banana, working hard, putting in that work.
Yeah, when the bananas get low, I'll stock some banana.
That was Sean dressing up for work for Halloween as a banana. And that's how he's working today. So it's great to look up doing your work to see a giant banana. So I went up and I talked to my buddy James up front. He's at the self-checkout. And he was like, I guess you heard she's coming back. I said, yeah, I heard. You know, news travels fast around here. And I was like, whatever. He was like, yeah, she was in here. I'm like, it's cool. And he was like, she showed me her new boyfriend. He looks like he hit every branch on the ugly tree on the way down. Like, talk about downgrading. I was like, that's what everybody says. And she keeps, like, posting pictures of him and showing people. Like, people are laughing at that. Like, definitely a downgrade. I had a shitty attitude, but I looked way better than that, dude. That's all I'm gonna say about that. But yeah, unfortunately, she's coming back. But you know what? I'm not gonna let that distract me and take my eye off the prize of my positive changes in my life. It's whatever. Come back, work. I don't care. I really don't give a shit anymore. I'm worried about me and improving my situation. Hopefully I'll be leaving soon anyway. People are like, that's not going to bother you? No. We worked together before, you know, when we split. It is what it is. This time I'm just not going to say shit to her. And today's Halloween, my favorite holiday. It was also our anniversary, so it's kind of weird. But I'm not letting it ruin my favorite holiday. You know, I'm really over that shit. And I talked to a girl all last night on the phone. One that I've been talking to for a while. And we just had a really good conversation until I went to bed. She's the one that was like, maybe you shouldn't fake your death. I'm like, I'm not faking my death. I didn't pay for an obituary, but I was like, you know, I'm trying to make positive changes in my life. She's like, I know, I've seen change in you. I was like, that's what I'm trying to do. She's like, I understand. I'm like happy-go-lucky, I'm like dancing through the aisles, I'm talking to people, like, just, I'm finally at peace with myself. After beating myself up, and sometimes I still do it a little bit. I'll beat myself up, but then I'm like, dude, it's the wrong attitude to have. I barely got any fucking sleep last night. I kept waking up and tossing and turning. Then my cat kept headbutting me. She doesn't know I gotta be up early. Yeah, I'm just trying to live my life, man. I'm trying to do positive things and what I have to do. I had to kill my old personality to get, you know, to where I wanted to be. Because I'm tired of costing myself things that mean shit to me. You know, this isn't the first relationship I've ruined. I've ruined a lot. Granted, this one affected me the most. Because I cared for this one the most, but other than that, it's just like every other breakup, you know. Once the initial shock and shit wears off, you're fine. As long as you keep saying to yourself, I'm making positive changes, you're fine. Clear everything out of your head. People knew what I was going through. Yeah, maybe at first didn't take it as well as I should have, but you live and you learn. That's what mistakes are that you make in life. Mistakes are lessons that you can always learn from. You know? So you don't do it the next time. Steroids and shit and antidepressants and alcohol and stuff was a mistake. Acting the ways that I did and acting erratic was a mistake. You know. Even though me and my ex don't like each other now, I still did have love for her. And I still did love her for the stuff she did to me, so I should have never hurt her like that. And I felt guilty about it. And I still feel bad. But I know I'm not the same person, you know. I know whatever I did in the past can't affect my future. You know? Yeah, it was wrong of me. And I still can't believe I acted that way. Because she didn't deserve it, you know? I was just out of my fucking mind. Out of my fucking mind. But I'm better now, you know? I'm choosing the life I want to live. And I'm making positive goals. And I'm making things happen. That's all I can do. I'm fixing myself. So when I do meet the right person or whatever else, I'm ready. You know? I've studied. I know the material. Now, once again, as I said last night, you know, I thank her for breaking my heart. Because I'm the best possible version I could be. It's a shame she's going to miss out. You know, because this is what she wanted me to be all along. And now I am. I mean, I didn't do it because of her. I did it because I knew it's what I had to do. And I was thinking of something last night. I was like, you know, I was mad at her about talking to a dude behind my back, but at the same time, I remember I did it once. I worked at Flying J, and the showers were down. They didn't have hot water. They were only spitting out cold water. So there was something wrong with, like, the hot water heater, so we had to wait for all the water to warm up. So this girl's with her dad, and she keeps coming up and talking to me because her dad's a truck driver. So before I leave, she goes, "Are you from around here?" I'm like, "Yeah, I live in Elkton." She goes, "Okay, I know where that is." So she's like, "Here's my phone number." Types it in my phone. So I call her up. My ex was at her Nana's house. Because that's where she lived before she moved in. So I stayed up and I talked to her for a while, that girl. And finally she goes, "Well, is it cool if I come over and chill for a little while?" You know. And then she starts talking about, like, sexual things. Granted, I'm in a relationship, so I'm like, I get cold feet. So I just stop answering her. She's blowing me up, texting me, calling me. "Where are you at? What's your address? I'm coming right now." And I just couldn't do it. So I pretty much ghosted her. And then I was like, wow. Like, I kind of was mad. And I did the same thing. I mean, granted, mine didn't go to the extreme. And that happened a lot. Not talking to girls, but, like, getting girls' numbers and stuff. And I didn't ask for them. They were just given to me. But I always threw them away or I didn't call them. I think that's the only time I ever talked to another chick like that. And there was this one girl when I worked at Flying J that had a huge crush on me. And I talked to her a couple times on Facebook. But it was nothing more than that. It was when me and Heather first started. She would make me, like, free breakfast sandwiches every morning. She would try to constantly come over to my house and hang out. And my ex hated her with a passion. I never did hang out with her. She had a man, too, but she didn't care. I did. You know, so now I think about it, I did do some shady stuff at the beginning. But I never went with anybody else or cheated. You know, because once I fuck with somebody, I fuck with them. You know. I try to be loyal. I try to show people respect. And if we're having problems, I'll sit you down and talk to you. You know, communication is the main part of a relationship. Like, if you want your partner to change, you got to talk to them. They're not going to know unless you bring it to their attention. That doesn't mean give up, you know, and go elsewhere. That means if you really want something and you've been together for years, you know, you got to talk. Once communication breaks down, you're doomed. You know, it's not going to work. That's the biggest part. And I learned is you constantly got to show somebody that you love them. Tell them how beautiful they are. You know, I did that for a while, but then, you know, I stopped doing it after a while. Because it's sort of like I'm taking things for granted. Like, I already have it, you know, why do I keep doing this? But it's important. You know, you got to make somebody feel loved and wanted and appreciated. And that, I think that's what, you know, our biggest problem was. And I learned that now. Every mistake I made from this one, I've learned. So that way, in my next relationship, I will be the best possible boyfriend any chick could have. Like, I'll listen, I'll be attentive, I'll love on you when you need it. When you're feeling down, I'll tell you you're beautiful. You know, I've learned so much. And, you know, I have said a lot of nasty things on here about my ex, but, you know, I did care for her very deeply. And it hurt when she left, you know. I'm better now, but that's why it hurt. And, you know, I didn't always show it or tell her, but, you know, I did love her very deeply. You know, she was my team partner, my best friend. She was there through so much bullshit that I went through. She stuck around with me when other people wouldn't. So, you know, this wasn't all negative. How it ended was negative, yeah. You know. I hate when things end on a negative note. And that's what happens when your communication breaks down. Or, you know. You know, somebody feels bored. Talk. Spice things up. That doesn't mean go somewhere else. Because eventually that relationship's going to get boring too. That's just relationships. They're fun at first. You know, through the puppy dog stages. But after that, you know, it's just like anything else. You know, I was trustworthy to her. I did everything, you know. I treated her good. We got along, or we wouldn't have been together as long as we were. You know. And I still think sometimes us breaking up was a mistake. Because of what we had for all those years, we could have, you know, continued to go. I mean, I know it's over. But I still think that sometimes. I'm like, man, you know. I still think this was a mistake. I was not, you know, working our problems out. Because it's hard to make a relationship work for as long as we did. You know, if you don't care about each other and you weren't in love. And you weren't soulmates. You know, things just got rough and one person left. It happens. That's relationships. But I still feel deep down, you know, that we were meant to be together. I know we're not. And I know we can't. But, you know, you can feel it when you know somebody. And it should have been fixed a long time ago, you know? It's just one of them things that are out of your control. You know, I saw some signs and I didn't do anything about it. That's why I'm changing myself. So I'm more attentive. So when I notice they're getting bored or something's wrong, I can talk to them. And we can fix things, you know? Like, it's a shame. This is a part, you know, all my girlfriends wanted out of me, like this version of me, and none of them get it. Like, I really have improved for the better. And none of them get that. And they would love it. Like, how I'm going to treat my next girl. That goes for all my exes that I fucked up over the years. For being stubborn and being pig-headed. But you learn, man. All your mistakes are just learning processes. Take the information you collected and fucking just do whatever you got to do. Things will work out for you in the end. You just got to stay positive and absolutely believe that. All right, well, I got to get back to work soon. I'm almost off my break. So happy Halloween, everybody, and be safe. All right, I'm Curb. And as always, I'm getting out of here. Oh, and to think I was almost married today. That would have been freaking crazy.